This is what perfection looks like. Quiet, clean, normal. Carl and Alice have the perfect life. Married fresh out of college. Alice, longing to grow a big happy family with a couple of kids. And Carl, graduated with honors and distinguished degrees that help him jumpstart his career path into the computer and rocket engineering world. Yep, life was perfect. In fact, it even seemed like the perfect time to... You see, there's been something slowly filling Alice's empty heart. And that is mindless shopping. But Carl doesn't mind, because he's just as excited to become a parent. And it makes Alice happy. It really didn't take these two lovebirds any time at all before they were expecting an addition to the household.
Jensiba.
Ooh.
You're big
Jensiba. Napsy.
Carl was more than delighted to hear the news and wanted to call and tell her mother, Macy, all about it. But that would mean also having to deal with Jayla, her sister. The professional bodybuilder already gives Alice a hard time about her body. The last thing she needs is for her to know that she will now be growing a watermelon-sized belly just in time for bikini season. Carl reassures her that she's beautiful no matter what, and even more so now because she's carrying his child. Oh my god, why am I ruining this poor man's life? Every Sunday is dinner at George and Macy's house. The last few years have been perfect with Jayla moving to Tartosa. She hasn't seen her sister for several years and would like to fool herself into thinking that she has forgotten all about Trevor. But has she? Luckily, George and Macy live nearby. In fact, they live right next door. Alice and Carl were gifted their home by Alice's parents when they exchanged their vows. Carl was more than gracious to accept, but Alice sees it as a passive-aggressive move on her father's behalf because he doesn't see Alice as successful as her sister, Jayla. George was never impressed with Carl, thought that he lacked a backbone for true business. But being the charismatic kingpin that he is, there is always room at his table for a man that respects and takes care of his baby girl. So, for now, he plays nice. Although, Carl quickly finds himself on the bottom of George's nice list when he yells at Mr. Jingles. No one yells at Mr. Jingles. Noticing the extra place settings at the table, Alice confronts her mother. No, Mom, don't tell me Jayla is back. Yes, your sister's back in town, and you and her are going to get along. I don't want to get along with her, Mom. She stole Trevor right out from under me. Oh, please, Alice. You were just a freshman, and they were seniors. He just happened to see you first and pick her in the end. Now get over it. You are happily married now, and you are going to leave your sister to her happiness, too. Mom, this isn't fair. You should have warned me that she was back.
Brapna! Sure.
Alice, not another word. I will not have this family split up over some petty high school crap. I am texting your sister, and that is that. Macy's so physically exhausted from the feud that has been going on between the girls for years. It has physically added years to her look. Oh no, it's Jayla and... Yep, just another normal family dinner. No unfaithful thoughts here. Jayla and Trevor have moved yet again. They have moved from Tartosa after filming the final season of Game of Groans. They are now just a 45-minute drive away from the city in Del Sol Valley. Alice liked it better when they lived in Tartosa. She couldn't just go and see them. It was much easier to keep Trevor out of her mind when he wasn't even around. Hey, Trevor. Still wearing that same body spray, huh? Oh. Now that Trevor and I are back in the city, we absolutely must get a babysitter to watch my little babies while we are away at work, and not just anyone will do. Oh, well, that's wonderful. Alice doesn't have a job and just sits at home with no kids to take care of. I'm sure she would love to do something, wouldn't you, Alice? Oh, They have very strict care instructions that you must follow exactly. I have all their doctor's information and emergency numbers. They eat only an all-natural diet and need plenty of exercise. Wouldn't want them to get a little pudge like you, huh, Alice? Oh, I'm just messing with you, Alice. You know we missed you. Yeah, I missed you too. I expect you to be at our house at 9 a.m. We work very demanding jobs and may have to call you on off hours, and you have to drop whatever you are doing and come take care of my babies. They cannot be left unattended. You have to take them with you wherever you go. I can trust you with this. Right, Alice? I mean, they are your niece and nephew. Yeah, I got this. Oh, Alice, you haven't changed. Still meek little Alice with no confidence. Do you still think everyone's talking about you too? Oh, Alice, why would they? I think that's probably about all the family time I can stand. Time to go home. Back to the dollhouse. How about we take a nice tour while I talk? This house is one of the original houses placed in this save file. I did not change any of the architecture of the house, I only changed the inside of the house to match the yellow and white theme of this generation. Now, this is normally where the Let's Play portion of the video would go. Normally. However, I recorded this video not once, but twice, and had audio corruption issues. I just took that as a sign that perhaps this legacy is better off portrayed in a Machinima style instead. Please let me know what your thoughts and opinions are down in the comments below. Do you like this more controlled, episodic style? Or with the more traditional Let's Play with the chaos that is The Sims 4 autonomy? Please let me know in the comments below which one you would rather see. In all honesty, the Machinimas are easier for me to make. I live in a pretty noisy household, so I don't have much time to actually record a quiet voice recording. And when you do a Let's Play, if you want a very entertaining episode, you can find yourself sometimes recording for up to 2-2.5 hours for just a 20-30 minute engaging episode. And of course, if you guys missed the introduction to the Crybaby Whims Legacy Challenge, then I will have the video up in the cards. You guys can click on that and you guys can see the introduction to all the characters, a lot of their fits, and a bit of a backstory. After returning home from dinner, Alice expressed her extreme annoyance with getting volunteered by her mother to watch Jayla's babies. I don't even know them, Carl. I have never even met them. I didn't even know Jayla and Trevor had kids. You had no idea? None. And to be voluntold by my mother? Ugh. I can't say no. Well, just think of it as practice before you give birth to our wonderful child, Alice. Of course, you're always right, Carl. It's just really hard to put our differences aside. Every time I see her, it just makes my blood boil. Maybe I just don't understand, but why does it bother you so much now? I'm tired, Carl. I think it's bedtime. The excitement that followed the announcement of her pregnancy faded to black, and her subconscious was filled with visions of Trevor. Alice always woke up before Carl so that she could make sure that he had breakfast and his clothes were set out for him for work. This day was like all the rest. So why did it feel so different? Alice didn't get much sleep. She tossed and turned and had nothing but dreams and memories of Trevor floating in and out of her consciousness. And the dreams were anything but pure and innocent. The idea of having to go to Jayla's home filled her with dread. And the thought of seeing Trevor again made her feel a way that she hasn't felt in a long time. And it scared her. Why did he have to pick her out of all people? It just had to be Jayla. Why her?
Good morning, beautiful. Wow, this looks delicious.
Thanks.
Are you all ready for your first day?
I wonder what their house looks like. I bet it's a mansion. Probably has a pool too. Maybe three. Maybe even a jacuzzi. And a personal chef. I was talking to Trevor last night and he said they didn't even have to lift a finger to move. Could you imagine? I mean, I know we didn't really have to lift a finger to move either because George did it all, but wow. Did you know that Trevor's a stunt double of being grown? How come you never told me that before? Alice?
Alice!
Make me groan! What? I mean, what?
Are you okay, Alice?
Yeah, I just, I'm sorry. You know how I feel about my sister, and now that I'm pregnant, I just feel so bloated and insecure right now. She decided to move back at just the wrong time.
Well, I have an idea that will make you feel better before you have to leave, beautiful.
Carl always knew how to make Alice feel loved and special, even in her deepest pits of self-doubt. And yeah, it works. After that eventful morning, it was time. Time to see Trevor. She does know he'll be at work, right? Welcome to Jayla's mansion. Nothing like having to walk up and face your fears, insecurities, and all your darkest, deepest disappointments all at once. And if you hadn't already guessed by now, Jayla's babies are four-legged and furry. Meet Whisper. She is a sweet cuddle bug that is anything but quiet. But she is Jayla's boss babe companion. And Onyx. He is her champion boy. He goes out on her with all of her runs, hikes, and even some competitions. Jayla loves her dogs so much, they even have their own bathroom, just for them. Jayla would never dream of having a nursery in her home, but a bedroom just for her pooches? That's exactly the kind of home that Jayla needs. Her house is so clean. Pristine. Sparkly, even. It looks like a show home. With trophies. And posters from their achievements decorating most of their walls. The kitchen doesn't even look like it's ever been used. Like Jayla just orders meals for everything, or has someone else make them and bring them for them. Maybe this is perfection. Up the stairs, we're greeted with yet more pictures of the two of them. Barf. And more movie posters. These posters are from movies that they helped actors get into shape for. And down this hallway leads into their bedroom. Have you guessed which one is her favorite yet? And of course, hanging right over their bed is another gag-me picture of Trevor and Jayla. Could you imagine if they did what they're supposed to do in this challenge in this bed with that picture over them? Off the bedroom is Jayla's closet. If there was anything that was going to make Alice even more jealous than she already is, it was this area. Just look at that tub. Alice's job is to make sure that the dogs don't make a mess while their masters are away. Yeah. But first, she has to say hi herself and see if they're even going to like her. They quickly take a liking to Alice. Maybe it's because her scent is so similar to their own mother's. Maybe one day, Whisper and Onyx, who are not related, might have a puppy, and then Alice can take one home. It would be nice to have a puppy to raise alongside the baby that she's currently growing. Even though they are well-trained dogs, they still seem to make mess after mess after mess. And nothing says that Alice cannot benefit from her sister's good fortune and hospitality. Might as well use some of the amenities around the house. And this yoga is really good for the baby. And I'm sure Jayla won't notice if Alice uses her brand new espresso machine. Nothing to notice here. Is espresso good for the baby? And say whatever you want to negatively about Jayla. But she definitely does love those dogs. Maybe even more than herself. This corner really gives Alice the creeps. Horror movies were never her favorite. Even the dogs stay away. But there's just something else about this corner. This bookcase. It just seems off. Something to explore another time, perhaps. After babysitting, Alice came home and was pleasantly surprised to see Carl and Macy talking about the new baby. Macy, putting on a happy face for Carl and then quickly a scowl for Alice, seemed delighted. Alice was just happy someone else cooked tonight. Mom, you didn't tell me my niece and nephew were dogs.
Dogs?
Oh, didn't I? I'm truly sorry, my dear. Must have slipped my mind. That's okay. I would much rather watch her furry children than any crotch goblin that came out of her. Alice May!
What? I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it.
When are you going to let this festering bitterness between you two go, Alice? It has been years. You are going to give yourself wrinkles. I'm sorry, Mom. I didn't mean any disrespect. I was just blindsided with her coming back into town all of the sudden. Well, that is understandable. Jayla does what Jayla does. Yeah, thanks for coming by, Mom, but you should really get home. Dad probably can't even figure out what to eat without you. You're right. That man can't do anything without me. And I'm pretty sure the food that Carl gave me is making me sick. So I'm going to go ahead and leave now. Good night, dear. Alice felt the same way about Carl. Could he even function without her? Does Alice really want to raise a child with a child? There's only one thing Alice wanted now, and that was sleep. Peaceful sleep. and lustful dreams about the last time that she was with Trevor, intimately. It was Halloween, and all the teens in the town dressed up as zombies, ghouls, goblins, and witches. It was on this night that Alice was a girl no longer, for on that night forward, she was his zombie forever.